People keep asking me to do a video on sugar, and I think I've been avoiding it because, if I'm honest with myself, I know I'm totally addicted to it. And it's not just that I have a sweet tooth. Scientifically speaking, my name is Jayde, and I'm a sugarholic. When we eat sugar, it has neurochemical effects on our brains, similar to that of other addictive drugs. We experience higher levels of opioids and dopamine, and that kind of chemical reward can be very addictive. Well, why do our bodies respond to sugar like it's crack cocaine? Well, because back in the caveman days, life was basically like a game of Mario Brothers, except instead of trying to find coins, we spent our whole day trying to find food. Sugar, like berries or honey, was basically the equivalent of finding Princess Peach. It was full of energy that our body needs, and when we found it, our brain was super happy and gave us all the reward chemicals. That's why sometimes you might eat your feelings. If you've ever eaten a pint of Ben & Jerry's to get over a bad breakup, you know what I'm talking about. But you can get addicted to that sugar reward. If a sugar addict like me stops eating sugar, you can get the same withdrawal symptoms as people coming off drugs, including cravings, anxiety, and even depression. That's why people who haven't eaten sugar in a while and have blue sugar content are called Hangry. They're literally angry because they're going through sugar withdrawal. The safe zone for sugar is about 6 teaspoons or less of added sugar per day, which is roughly 25 grams or about 100 calories worth, according to the American Heart Association. But sadly, a recent report from the University of North Carolina revealed that the average American triples this quota, and about 1 in 5 people, you know who you are, exceeds 700 calories of added sugar on a daily basis. That means eating an entire cup of extra sugar each and every day. Okay, so we know that sugar is powerful, and we know that most people eat too much. But what happens if you stop eating sugar? Well, firstly, you'll probably avoid type 2 diabetes. In one study, researchers found that eating 150 calories of added sugar is 11 times more likely to contribute to the development of type 2 diabetes compared to the same amount of calories from protein or even fat. Secondly, research shows your risk of dying from heart-related causes will reduce if you cut out the sugar. Added sugar increases insulin levels, which activates the sympathetic nervous system, which increases your blood pressure and your heart rate, kind of like cocaine. It will only take a few weeks of added sugar for your cholesterol, triglycerides, and blood pressure to show significant decreases. Sugar is a natural inflammatory, and systematic inflammation is a known trigger of acne and zits. A study by the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition shows that when non-soda drinkers consume 1 12-ounce can of soda per day for 3 weeks, their inflammation levels increased by 87%. And if clear skin isn't enough of an incentive for you, then what about weight loss? When you scale back your sugar habit by 200 calories per day, you could lose 10 pounds in just 5 months. And if you're swapping sugary foods for foods higher in protein, you probably won't be eating as many calories overall, and you'll feel fuller longer. So not only will you be healthier long-term and look great, but cutting down your sugar intake will help you feel better on the inside. One study from Columbia University found that women who eat diets high in added sugar are more likely to experience anxiety, irritability, and mood swings. I think we both know we could do with less of that nonsense. And if you're someone who struggles with memory or experiences brain fog, cutting out sugar could help with that too. A study at UCLA concluded that a diet high in added sugar hinders learning and memory. And over time, eating high amounts of sugar could even damage communication along brain cells. Eating a diet high in sugar can make you stupid? Well, I'm done then. So tell us honestly, are you addicted to sugar too? It's okay, you can confess. Which of these health benefits is most likely to motivate you to reduce your sugar intake? We'd love to hear your sweet stories in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching SciQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.